Okay, here we have the freaking awesome welding table. Steve's getting ready to jack it up and turn it over. Yeah, let's not reach under there. Can't really see it.
Come in here and try.
Okay, you can see the rigging up there. Hopefully everything is strong, because this table is really big and freaking awesome heavy.
Yeah, well, that's what I've got to work with, so I'm making it work.
Okay, I'm backing back out. I think that was the wind.
The wind blowing the sheet on the side of the way there.
Looking all right.
Has to do the same kind of deal. See, I've got the chain wrapped around each leg, and then it goes underneath the table and up the backside.
So yes.
And then as you crank it, it just lifts it up, and eventually it'll get to the point where it wants to flip over. And then at that point, we have to control it so it doesn't flop over.
Okay, doing the close-up thing.
Try to break our leg or anything. So I've got that 2x4 there to try to control the
come around
the
side.
The flop when it starts to want to flop.
Good strong chain. I don't know about that though.
Yeah, it's okay. We're not lifting that much weight at this point. We're not actually lifting, we're just rolling over actually.
Huh. Yeah, what are you going to do to keep it from flopping over?
Well, that's what that 2x4 is supposed to do. Try to help keep that thing from getting out of control.
We are silently sinking. Oh, I see.
It's ready to, if it gets upright, it's going to want to flip over and it's going to land right on those wheels. It's just going to put a lot of strain on that whole setup there, and I'd like to maybe not have that be so such an abrupt.
Oh yeah, I see what you mean.
I'm not really sure at this point what I can do about it.
Yeah, because you don't want to have the wheels snap off if it just...
We got some tires over here. Put these tires.
Oh, there you go. Put the tires in there. You don't want some on the other side too?
No. Not even sure. I want that two of those in there. I suppose I should have got the water out of them before I threw them in the gun.
Okay.
See how it's got slack in that chain now?
Yeah.
It wants to flip over right now. I'm not going to hit anything down that way, are we?
I don't think so. Here she goes.
Once more. That's as far as it wants to go right now because that 2x4 is holding us up.
So you have to move it? Be careful.
Yeah.
Yay!
Worked the way I wanted it to.
Awesome.
Okay, now what we're going to do, we're going to re-rig, we're going to hook up over there and pull this way, and I will
stand it up. Awesome. Thank you. rearranging the rigging.
Who needs tuner anyway?
Really?
All we do is confuse the issue.
Probably fall off the ladder and break something. Here we go, rearranging the rigging. Gonna move it over to the left. Bring the table up on all four wheels. Say a few words there, Mr. Blacksmith.
What do you think? I think it's working.
I think it's working.
Rigger extraordinaire.
She go. She definitely go.
If you can't be strong, be smart.
Yes.
If you can be strong and smart, that's even better.
I've got a battery light going off. We may run out of battery light here. Is it going to run into that pole?
Huh?
Is it going to run into that board pole there?
I hope not. Not supposed to. I want to. Thank you. hope I don't run out of pull here. I might have to reset the chain to get enough pull. Yeah, I'm going to have to. I'm going to run out of pulling room on this. Reset this.
Ooh.
Now, we need to figure out what we're going to grab this chain with so we can get a shorter grab on it. This is why you carry stuff around for years, so you can have stuff to work with when the time comes.
He is recalibrating his rigging here to make it shorter so it'll go quicker, I think.